CIET, NCERT presents audiobook of Science for Class 6, entitled Science 1. This is the lesson 16, titled Garbage In, Garbage Out, from page 155 to page 165. Page 155. Let's listen to the lesson 16, Garbage In, Garbage Out. We throw out so much rubbish or garbage every day from our homes, schools, shops and offices. The grains, pulses, biscuits, milk or oil purchased in shops are packed in plastic bags or tins. All these wrapping material go out as garbage. We sometimes buy things that are rarely used and often thrown into the garbage. We generate so much garbage in our day-to-day activities. We often throw groundnut shells on public places, in buses or trains, after eating the nuts. We throw away the ticket when we get off a bus. A child might go on sharpening pencils just for fun. If we make mistakes or spill ink on our notebook, we tear off the sheet and throw it away. And we also throw away many domestic wastes, such as broken toys, old clothes, shoes, and slippers. What if the garbage is not removed from our homes and surroundings? How do you think this will harm us? When Safai Karmacharis take the garbage from the bins, where does the garbage go and what happens to it? Is it possible for all of this garbage to be changed into something that will not harm us? Can we contribute towards this in any way? We will look for answers to these questions in this chapter. A Step Towards Cleanliness, Swachh Bharat. The Prime Minister of India launched the Swachh Bharat Mission, SBM. The aim of this mission is to create an open defecation-free India by 2 October 2019. Children from Paheli and Bujho's school did a project called Dealing with Garbage. We will learn about some of the things they learned through this project. 16.1 Dealing with garbage. Safai Karmacharis collect the garbage in trucks and take it to a low-lying open area called a landfill. Figure 16.1. There, the part of the garbage that can be reused is separated out from the one that cannot be used as such. Figure 16.1 shows a landfill. Page 156. Thus, the garbage has both useful and non-useful components. The non-useful component is separated out. It is then spread over the landfill and then covered with a layer of soil. Once the landfill is completely full, it is usually converted into a park or a playground. For the next 20 years or so, no building is constructed on it. To deal with some of the useful components of garbage, compost-making areas are developed near the landfill. What is compost? Let us learn about it from the following activity. Paheli did wonder as to what could be useful garbage. Why was it thrown away in the first place? Is there some garbage that is not actually garbage? Activity 1. Collect the garbage from your house before it is thrown into the dustbin. Separate it into two groups so that they have Group 1, garbage from the kitchen, like fruit and vegetable peels, eggshells, waste food, tea leaves. Include newspapers, dry leaves and paper bags in this group. Group 2, pieces of cloth, polythene bags, broken glass, aluminium wrappers, nails, old shoes and broken toys. Now divide the contents of each group into two separate heaps. Label them as A, B, C and D. put one heap from group 1 and one heap from group 2 into two separate plastic bags. Tie the mouth of these two bags tightly. Put all the four heaps in separate pits and cover them with soil. Figure 16.2. You can also use four pots to bury these garbage heaps. Remove the soil after 4 days and observe the changes in the garbage. A black color and no foul smell indicates that rotting of garbage is complete. Put the heaps again in the pits and cover with the soil. Observe again after every 2 days and note your observations as suggested. Did the garbage 1. Rot completely and not smell? 2. Rot only partially? 3. Rot almost completely but still smells bad? 4. Not change at all? Garbage in which heap was seen to rot and which did not? Enter options 1, 2, 3 or 4 in the columns of table 16.1 based on your observations. Figure 16.2 shows putting garbage heaps in pits. Page 157. If you make any other observations, do not forget to write all these down in your notebook. Do not remove and burn the garbage that did not rot. Table 16.1. What has happened to the garbage heaps? There are 5 columns. One is for garbage heap named as heap A, heap B, heap C, heap D. Second is for after 4 days. Third column is for after 6 days. Fourth column is for after 2 weeks. And fifth column is for after 4 weeks. Now, complete this table according to your observation as suggested. If the garbage was found to rot completely and did not smell, mix it in the soil where you sow your favorite plants. This would provide nutrients to the plants. You must have observed from this activity that some things in the garbage rot. They form manure which is used for the plants. The rotting and conversion of some materials into manure is called composting. In some cities and towns, municipalities provide separate dustbins for collecting 2 kinds of garbage. Usually, one is colored blue and the other is green. The blue bin is for materials that can be used again, such as plastics, metals, and glass. Did you notice that these are the materials that do not rot in the garbage heaps? The green bins are for collecting kitchen and other plant or animal wastes. You may have noticed that this type of wastes rot completely when buried in the soil. Do you see why it is necessary for us to separate waste into 2 groups as we did in activity 1 before we throw it? Have you noticed garbage heaps of dried leaves on the roadside? Most of the time, these are burnt. Figure 16.3. Farmers too often burn the husk, dried leaves and part of crop plants in their fields after harvesting. Burning of these produces smoke and gases that are harmful to our health. We should try to stop such practices. These wastes could be converted into useful compost. Here is the figure given. Figure 16.3 shows burning of leaves produce harmful gases. Here are some of the observations and thoughts noted by Paheli and Bujho from their project Dealing with Garbage. Bujho noted in his notebook, "Do not burn leaves. You will not be able to tolerate the fumes." Page 158. Paheli made a note in her notebook. Why has the government not made burning of leaves a theft? Not theft really, She must have meant illegal. She wanted that the government should make a law against the burning of leaves and other plant wastes anywhere in India. 16.2. Vermi composting. We can be friends of plants by supplying them with compost. We will also be very good friends to ourselves by making compost. Talking of friends, do you know that earthworms are called farmer's friend? Let us find out how a type of earthworm called red worm is used for composting. This method of preparing compost with the help of red worms is called vermicomposting. We can try to make manure by vermicomposting at school. Activity 2. Let us dig a pit about 30 cm deep or keep a wooden box at a place which is neither too hot nor too cold. What about a place which does not get direct sunlight? Let us now make a comfortable home for our red worms in the pit or the box. Spread a net or chicken mesh at the bottom of the pit or the box. You can also spread 1 or 2 cm thick layer of sand as an alternative. Now, spread some more vegetable wastes, including peels of fruits, over this layer of sand. One can also use green leaves, pieces of dried stalks of plants, husk or pieces of newspaper or cardboard to spread cover the layer of sand. However, shiny or plastic coated paper should not be used for this purpose. Dried animal dung could also be used as a spread over sand or wire mesh. Sprinkle some water to make this layer wet. Take care not to use excess of water. Do not press the layer of waste. Keep this layer loose so that it has sufficient air and moisture. Now, your pit is ready to welcome the red worms. Buy some red worms and put them in your pit. Figure 16.4. Cover them loosely with a gunny bag or an old sheet of cloth or a layer of grass. Here is the figure given, figure 16.4, which shows red worms. Your red worms need food. You can give them vegetable and fruit wastes, coffee and tea remains, and weeds from the fields or garden. Figure 16.5. It might be a good idea to bury this food about 2 to 3 cm inside the pit. Page 159. Do not use wastes that may contain salt, pickles, oil, vinegar, meat and milk preparations as food for your red worms. If you put these things in the pit, disease-causing small organisms start growing in the pit. Once in a few days, gently mix and move the top layers of your pit. Red worms do not have teeth. They have a structure called gizzard, which helps them in grinding their food. Powdered eggshells or seashells could be mixed with the wastes. This would help red worms in grinding their food. A red worm can eat food equal to its own weight in a day. Red worms do not survive in very hot or very cold surroundings. They also need moisture around them. If you take good care of your worms, in a month's time, their number will be double. Observe the contents of the pit carefully after 3 to 4 weeks. Do you now see loose, soil-like material in the pit? Your vermicompost is ready. Figure 16.6. Put some wastes as food in one corner of the pit. Most of the worms will shift towards this part of the pit, vacating the other part. Remove the compost from the vacated part and dry it in the sun for a few hours. Your vermicompost is ready for use. The part left in the pit has most of the worms in it. You can use these for preparing more compost or share them with another user. Figure 16.5 shows food for red worms. Here is the figure given. Figure 16.6 shows vermicomposting. Use this excellent vermicompost in your pots, gardens, or fields. Is this not like getting the best out of waste? Those of you who have agricultural fields can try vermicomposting in large pits. You can save a lot of money that is spent on buying expensive chemical fertilizers and manure from the market. 16.3. Think and throw. How much of garbage do you think is thrown out by each house every day? You can make an estimate by using a bucket as a measure. Use a 5 to 10 liter bucket to collect the garbage from your home for a few days. In how many days does the bucket become full? Page 160. You know the number of members in your family. If you find out the population of your city or town, can you now estimate the number of buckets of garbage that may be generated in a day in your city or town? We are generating mountains of garbage every day, isn't it? Figure 16.7. Here is the figure given. Figure 16.7 shows neighborhood garbage dump. Let us read a story about a village where there is less garbage and more wisdom. Nanu studies in class 6. He is very fond of making paper planes. His mother is very annoyed when he tears off sheets from new notebooks to make aeroplanes. But Nanu does not care. Once, Nanu went to his aunt's village along with his mother. He was amazed at the variety of things his cousin Shyam had made. Files from old charts, greeting cards decorated with flowers made from pencil shavings, mats from old clothes, baskets from used old polythene bags were some of the items Nanu liked. Shyam had even made a diary from invitation cards. One morning, Nanu went looking for his grandmother, Nani. He saw that she was applying a thick paste on a basket. Nanu asked, "Nani, what are you doing? What is this paste?" "This is paper mache, a paste made of clay and paper in which I have also mixed some rice husk," replied Nani.
"But why are you putting it on the basket?" asked Nanu.
"To make it stronger," said Nani, and added, "Would you like to learn this from me?"
Nanu was not very keen and ran outside to play. He was only interested in tearing up papers to make planes. In fact, he also started tearing up papers from Shyam's files. Shyam collected all the pieces of paper Nanu had used, wondering what to do about him. He just did not listen to anyone. It was Nanu's birthday in a few days. Shyam planned to invite Nanu's friends. Nanu took out money from his mud pot and went to the market. He bought some paper hats for his friends. He asked the shopkeeper for a polythene bag to keep the hats, who gave him a paper bag instead of polythene. Nanu also bought many other items like biscuits and toffees. He found it difficult to carry all of these things as no shopkeeper was ready to give a polythene bag. Shyam had told him to carry a cloth bag with him, and he was sorry he did not listen to him. Somehow, he managed to reach home with all his purchases. Figure 16.8. Nanu's friends enjoyed the feast on his birthday and played many games. Page 161. Figure 16.8 shows Nanu with bags full of purchases. All his friends wore the shiny paper hats Nanu had bought. Shyam had made beautiful paper mache masks for Nanu's friends. He had a special gift for Nanu as well. A photo frame and a greeting card made from the paste of all the pieces of paper Nanu had thrown away. It was a new experience for Nanu. All his friends went home with their masks. Nanu was too excited to finish his meal and look at his gifts. Nanu returned home after his holidays were over. How different his town was from Shyam's village! There were no rag pickers in the village as it was neat and clean. But now he stopped making faces when he saw the rag picking children near his house. You might have seen some children sorting the garbage near your house or at other places. Observe the children at work and find out how they separate useful material from the garbage. They are actually helping us. Talk to one such child and find out what they do with the rubbish they collect. Where do they take it? Does he or she go to school? What about his or her friends? If they do not go to school, find out the possible reasons. Can you help this child to read and write? Have you ever helped at home to sell old newspapers, glass and metal things, plastic bags and your old notebooks to a garbage dealer? Talk to him and find out what he does with all the garbage. Would you like to make paper from old and discarded paper like Shyam? Let us learn to do this. 16.4 Recycling of paper. You will require pieces of old newspapers, magazines, used envelopes, notebooks or any other paper. Do not use shiny plastic coated paper. You will also need a frame fitted with a wire mesh or a net. You can also use a large sized sieve in place of a frame. Tear the paper into small pieces. Put them in a tub or a bucket and pour water in it. Let the pieces of paper remain submerged in water for a day. Make a thick paste of paper by pounding it. Now, spread the wet paste on the wire mesh fixed to the frame. Pat it gently to make the thickness of layer of the paste as uniform as possible. Wait till water drains off. If required, spread an old cloth or a sheet of newspaper on the paste to let it soak up the extra water. Page 162. Now, carefully remove the layer of paste from the frame. Spread it on a sheet of newspaper in the sun. Keep the corners of the newspaper sheet pressed by putting some weights so that these do not curl up. You can add food color, pieces of dry leaves or flower petals or pieces of colored paper in the paste before spreading it. It would help you to get a recycled paper with beautiful patterns on it. Can we recycle everything just as we recycle paper? 16.5 Plastics. Boon or a curse? Some kind of plastics can be recycled, but not all of them. Did you notice that polythene bags and some plastics did not rot in activity 1? You might now easily understand why polythene bags create big problem in garbage disposal. It may be a little difficult to imagine our life without plastics. Shall we list a few things we use that are made of plastics? Toys, shoes, bags, pens, combs, toothbrushes, buckets, bottles and water pipes. The list is very long. Can you name a few parts of a bus, car, radio, television, refrigerator and a scooter that are made of plastics? The use of plastics in itself might not create so much of a problem. Problems arise when we use plastics excessively and are ignorant about ways of disposing their waste. This is what is happening all around us. We might even be acting irresponsibly, knowing well about its harmful effects. We often use plastic bags to store cooked food items. Sometimes these bags may not be suitable for keeping eatables. Consuming food packed in such plastic bags could be harmful to our health. Many a time, shopkeepers use plastic bags that have been used earlier for some other purpose. Sometimes bags collected by rag pickers are also used after washing them. Use of such recycled plastic bags to keep food items could be harmful for our health. For storing eatables, we must insist on use of plastic bags that are approved for such a use. All kind of plastics give out harmful gases upon heating or burning. These gases may cause many health problems, including cancer, in humans. The government has also laid down guidelines for recycling of plastics. Paheli would like to suggest that containers used for storing poisonous substances should be recycled separately, and that such recycled plastics are not used to make plastic bags. You must have noticed that people often fill garbage in plastic bags and then throw it away. When stray animals look for food in these bags, they end up swallowing these. Sometimes they die due to this. The plastic bags thrown away carelessly on roads and other places get into drains and the sewer system. Page 163. As a result, drains get choked and the water spills on the roads. During heavy rains, it might even create a flood-like situation. There is a lot of harm that too much use of plastics can do. What can we do to minimize overuse of plastics and deal with garbage? 1. We make a minimum use of plastic bags. We reuse the bags whenever it is possible to do so without any adverse effects. 2. We insist shopkeepers use paper bags. We carry a cloth or a jute bag when we go out for shopping. 3. We do not use plastic bags to store eatables. 4. We do not throw plastic bags here and there after use. 5. We never burn plastic bags and other plastic items. 6. We do not put garbage in plastic bags and throw it away. 7. We use vermicomposting at home and deal with our kitchen waste usefully. 8. We recycle paper. 9. We use both sides of the paper to write. We use a slate for rough work. We use blank sheets of paper left in our notebooks for rough work. 10. We make our family, friends and others to follow proper practices for disposing different kinds of wastes. Think about some more ways to minimize overuse of plastics and discuss. The most important point to know and think about is that more garbage we generate, more difficult it will be to get rid of it. Keywords: waste, garbage, landfill, compost, vermicomposting, recycling. Here Bujo and Paheli suggesting, let us refuse plastic. Summary: landfill is an area where the garbage collected from a city or town is dumped. The area is later converted into a park. Converting plant and animal waste, including that from kitchen, into manure is called composting. Page 164. The method of making compost from kitchen garbage using red worms is called vermicomposting. Paper can be recycled to get useful products. Plastics cannot be converted into less harmful substances by the process of composting. We need to generate less waste and find ways of dealing with the increasing amount of garbage in our surroundings. Exercises: 1A. Which kind of garbage is not converted into compost by the red worms? B. Have you seen any other organism besides red worms in your pit? If yes, try to find out their names. Draw pictures of these. 2. Discuss. A. Is garbage disposal the responsibility only of the government? B. Is it possible to reduce the problems relating to disposal of garbage? 3A. What do you do with the leftover food at home? B. If you and your friends are given the choice of eating in a plastic plate or a banana leaf platter at a party, which one would you prefer and why?
4A. Collect pieces of different kinds of paper. Find out which of these can be recycled.
B. With the help of a lens, look at the pieces of paper you collected for the last question. Do you see any difference in the material of recycled paper and a new sheet of paper?
5A. Collect different kinds of packaging material. What was the purpose for which each one was used? Discuss in groups.
B. Give an example in which packaging could have been reduced.
C. Write a story on how packaging increases the amount of garbage.
6. Do you think it is better use compost instead of chemical fertilizers? Why?
Activity for dealing with garbage. 1. Collect old and discarded objects and material like glass bottles, plastic bottles, coconut husk, wool, bed sheets, greeting cards, and any other thing. Can you make something useful out of these instead of throwing them? Try.
2. Prepare a detailed project report on compost making activity you did in school. Page 165.
A matter of concern. In autumn, lots of leaves are burnt in cities like Delhi. Some of the gases produced by burning leaves are similar to the gases released by the vehicles moving on the roads. Instead of burning, if we make compost from these leaves, we can reduce the use of chemical fertilizers. The green areas which should have fresh air actually become full of harmful gases due to burning of leaves. If you find anyone is burning the leaves, bring it to notice of municipal authorities or write to newspapers about it. Generate social pressure against burning of leaves. Ensure that fallen leaves are not burnt but used for making compost. Write to the tree authority of your city or state to declare burning of leaves as an offense. Chapter 16, which is the last chapter of this book, ends here. Narrator, Shamaila Parvez. Producer, Vandana Arimardhan. Presented by CIET, NCERT, New Delhi, India.